What's up, everybody? My name is Jorge Lopez, also known as Jay Toxic. I'm an up-and-coming DJ right now in the southeastern Wisconsin. Mostly Racine, Kenosha, trying to get to Milwaukee area, you know, once I get out there a little bit. So today, I want to talk about Harbinger speakers that I bought for my system. When I first got everything, I didn't, like, I followed directions, tried to put everything piece together, you know, piece by piece. One thing I had problems with was I got here, comes with a package. So this whole set I bought from Guitar Center in Brookfield. Amazing place. Man, they can have everything you possibly need. This is a LV7 mixer that I got for my system. So the issue I was having was trying to connect the subwoofers. So I got two, as you can see here, two 12-inch Harbinger V2312 speakers with the S12 subwoofer to go with it. And these babies kick. It's a good system for me starting out. I had one 12-inch speaker, which somewhere around here, I had bought for basic. So this was a nice step up, even for me just beginning. But today I want to talk to you guys about trying to help set everything up. You know, I had little problems at the beginning. I wasn't, like, everything I was putting together wasn't working. So I'm gonna go through it step by step. So anybody else that's new beginner, doesn't know what they're doing, I'm gonna help you out. All right, guys, so I got us a little closer. Sorry if picture quality is still not good. I'm just running off my iPhone, still beginning, you know what I'm saying? So here we have 12-inch speaker, sub, mixer. One thing I do wanna add though, of course, me beginning, you know, being freshly new to the industry, I got a Hercules Impulse 500 for my deck, right? That's what I mix on. Now when I first started, I remember I said I had that one speaker that I used when I first started. So I was able to use that with RCA cables, you know, it was just RCA in the mixer, RCA to the speaker. Bought these bad boys for an event. 2 days prior, did not realize that, well, there's nowhere to hook up RCA. It's mono only, XLR. I didn't know what that was. I had to look it up. Went back to Guitar Center. For me, it's about a 45-minute drive. So it did suck that I was there prior, not too long before that, to buy this whole set, not realizing that I would need one cord adapter just so I can play my mixer to the speakers to play music. So, of course, you know, RCA right here, two cords, and quarter-inch XLRs. Those are gonna plug into right here. Sorry about that. As you can see, I got four channels. So the left side right here, channel 2, channel 3, 4, and 5 on the right. Now, what's dope is that, you know, with these, you can hook up a guitar to it, you know, any other instrument that you can hook up using XLR. You go straight to the mixer. You got the mic. Headphones, you control the volume on that right here if you want to. I still use it on the mixer. And what's nice about these speakers is that you right here, as you can see, we got mono here, so you can hook up guitar here. And on the left side, you can also hook up a mic, as you can see, guitar too. So it's got mic, guitar, and line. If you weren't using this mixer, you can actually control the bass and treble on the speakers themselves. I know I haven't been out there long enough, but these things do great for what I'm doing, just starting out right now. So that being said, starts off input 1 right here on the left side. If anybody has these speakers, they don't know how to hook them up yet, you know, if you're starting out like I was. So on line 1, you're gonna put that where it says L on the main outs of your mixer right here. So you're gonna go left and input 1, right input 2. So let's see if I can hook that up real quick. Input 1 here, left on the mixer, as you can see right there, before that falls. Of course, like I said, right 2. Now output 2, you can put to whatever speaker you have on the right side. So however you have your setup for your speakers, for whatever the event that you're DJing for, you would just put that speaker cord, connect to that. Now, when you do that, you're gonna connect whatever output you put it into, You're gonna wanna put it to LinkedIn right here on the speaker. So what you can do, say if I wasn't using the subwoofer, we have out right here on top of it, right? So you hook up one of these on outs and then plug in to where it says LinkedIn on the other speaker. Now for that, what you're gonna do is you're gonna have it to, one of the speakers is gonna be set to LinkedIn. Actually, no, sorry, I take that back. Stereo master. So whichever one you want full control of, that's gonna be the stereo master. Other speaker, of course, LinkedIn. So that way, you know, they both connect together. Control the bass, treble on those speakers for that occasion. But, another nice feature, Bluetooth. Think of Bluetooth, friggin' awesome. Say you got a small outdoor event, whatever. Forget your cords, or you don't want to use your cords. You know, you want it somewhere close by. You can hook up Bluetooth to it. Everything will still connect. I love it. Dope. So that's how that works. You got your controller bass right here, the crossover frequency. I noticed this in my last event I did. So obviously I got 12, right? Left side is going to say 12 or 15 inch speakers. Right side, you got your 8 or 10 inch speakers. And about 80 hertz, 80 to 90 is about good where I want to be for now. Just starting out, I don't want to blow these things just yet. But even at 90, these things, man, it puts a lot of bass. It's really nice. I love it. You got your main control here. You can still control the volume on here and on the deck. And these things are amazing. So if you have any questions, go ahead and put it in the comment section. I will do my best to give you an answer. As I said, I'm still learning myself. And, you know, look up other videos. You know, that's how I started with this. I was looking up Harbinger videos and how to set this up. Of course, everybody just, they'll tell you how to set it up. They'll say what they're doing, but they don't actually give you the lowdown. Here, I want to actually give you an eye view of what you're actually doing. You know what I'm saying? So you got input one with left on the main out. Those two go together. Right with output two. Or no, take that back. Input, sorry. Out, main outs to the inputs. The outputs on the subwoofer are going to go to your speakers. All right, so here I got my left speaker at the right. Got my sub on the bottom right there. My mixer, and I use DJ Serato Pro. And here is the mixer. So as you can see, left, right. Input one, main outs to input one on the sub. Main outs to input two on the sub. And then here are my XLRs that go to my RCAs right here. Comes right out of my deck. And once you got all that together, make sure, like I said before, that you got on the speaker, turn that off, make sure it's set to LinkedIn. So you want LinkedIn for these systems to work. Once you got that all set, you're good to go. Machiavellian is Illuminati, all through your body, the blows like a 12 gauge shot. Alright guys, and that's my video for today. I really hope this helped people out. Like I said, you know, it was a bit confusing for me at first. I had to actually ask somebody at the Guitar Play Center that I went to, and it could have been more easier once I've had everything, once I was instructed what I had to do. But you know, I had that mentor to help me, you know, and that really went a long way. So anybody has got questions, I will try to answer the best I can. And any DJs have been doing this for a long time, you know, you got anything to say about my setup, about you know, what I could be doing differently, or you know, just explain something else, I'm open to anything. I'm still trying to learn myself still. I've only been doing this for like since June. So I mean, anything that you guys can say to help me out too, that'd be awesome. Please give my channel a like and subscribe if you had a great time watching this, and I'll be making some more videos soon. Thank you.